So my dear students, welcome again to my channel and lecture number 3 of electrotherapy. In first and second lecture, we have discussed about electromagnetic spectrum, ultraviolet rays. Where do ultraviolet rays stand in electromagnetic spectrum? Therapeutic production of ultraviolet rays, that is through high pressure mercury vapor lamps like air cooled lamps, also known as sun alpine halogen lamps, Hanovia sun alpine lamps. Okay, then your water cooled lamps, also known as chromium lamps, fluorescent tubes, and your thoracotid tunnel setup. So we have already understood in our previous two lectures that how we can generally therapeutically produce ultraviolet rays. Now the basic difference between ultraviolet and any other therapeutic modality is, in UVR treatment, one cannot give or increase the dosage without any predetermined value. This means that we need to know the minimum dosage value for the treatment. Now, primary main aim of testing for UVR dosage is to generate erythema. Now, what does erythema means? Yes, erythema is nothing but redness of the skin. Yes, so as I said, unlike other electrotherapeutic modalities like your IFT, shortwave diathermy, Russian currents, low frequency currents, ultrasound, yes, in this, you in these mentioned therapies, you can increase the intensity based on the dosages, and there is no as such criteria that how you are supposed to increase the intensity. But in ultraviolet radiations, one has to predetermine a minimal dosage required to generate erythema. Okay, minimal dosage required to generate erythema. So in test dosage, what are we going to find out? Yes, we are going to find out the minimum dosage of ultraviolet rays required to generate erythema. This is known as minimal erythema. even dosage MEP. Yes. So my dear students, please understand that in minimal erythemal dosage, we are practically inducing erythema. This means we are testing that part, okay, of an individual where the dosage is need to be tested, and after that dosage, yes, erythema is going to happen. So this means this means that minimal erythemal dosage is subjective. My dear students, please understand this sentence very, very, very carefully. This means every tested patient of minimum of for UVR will have a different minimal erythema dosage based on the skin type which we are going to discuss today. Yes, so this subjective, this MED basically depends upon following parameters. First one is skin type of the individual. Second one is type of lamp. Third one is distance between the lamp and the testing site. So in this three parameters, minimal erythemal dosage, yes, depends. I am going on very slowly in this lecture. The only reason is because this is very, very, very important part of UVR. Right. Certain books have mentioned that an average output of the lamp is considered as minimal erythemal dosage. As per standard books like Electrotherapy Explained, John Law and Reed, this is meaningless. And I also agree that this is meaningless, that finding out the average output of the lamp, minimal erythemal dosage, yes, is always going to be meaningless, because as we all know that output of the lamp as on when is going to decrease day by day or with its use, because of tridymite formations and because of the various coating level differences, and also there would be voltage fluctuations. Third, also the distance matters of the lamp and the testing site or the treatment site. So the average finding of lamp output is always a meaningless question. Yes, so we are going to discuss in very much detail about this. So that is why this dosage part is divided into part one and part two. In part one, we will just discuss the basics of UVR test dosage, and in part two, we would discuss the advanced, that how the dosage is progressed. Yes, with the same distance and with if the distance is changed. Clear? So my dear students, we would now move ahead for the testing dosage side. Yes, I would like to request you all that please understand this very carefully, because this is the main part of UVR. Okay. Yes. So now, what are we going to see? Yes. Test dosage. As I said, the test dosage is basically used to assess the individual patient's erythemal reaction to the UVR. So what we are doing, we are inducing the erythema in a patient, and how does the patient's skin react to this UVR, that is known as erythemal reaction. The basis of any calculation of UVR dosage is the minimal erythemal dosage, which I've already mentioned. That is why we need to have a minimal erythemal dosage. Yes. So this is the minimum quantity of UVR irradiation. Yes. Of UVR irradiation. Okay. Minimum quantity of UVR irradiation, which is required to produce erythema. Clear? This MED refers to the response of erythema for the dosage which is supposed to be given. So based on this minimal erythemal dosages, we can then progress to E2, E3, E4. Clear? Again, there are certain books which say that minimal erythemal dosages is equivalent to E1. John Law and Reed electrotherapy book says it is equivalent to E1. But certain books say that minimal erythemal dosage is different. E1 is different, E2 is different, and E3 is different. So the books which state that there is only E1, E2, E3, they consider minimal erythemal dosage as a separate entity. Whereas the books which say that in MED and E1 are equal, so there is E2, E3 and E4. Okay. We would see all these things in detail in our video. This minimal, the patient must understand the purpose of MED test. Okay. So it is obvious that if you are doing if you are giving the test dosage, UVR irradiation, what you are expecting? You are expecting a erythema. Okay. You are expecting a erythema to be present. So what will patient do? If you are given erythema is nothing but redness. So if there is a redness of the skin, patient will become tensed. So patient should understand, must understand that the purpose of MED is to determine just how much exposure time is necessary based on the skin sensitivity. Okay. So it is nothing much to worry about. Okay. So what things we are supposed to do? Okay. We are supposed to wear goggles. Okay. Patient is supposed to wear goggles. Observe and monitor skin condition. Keep the skin moist before the exposure of UVR. Okay. Pigmentation changes are to be expected and are normal response. This is what we are thinking about. This is nothing but your erythema. Prolonged and repeated exposure can lead to prematurizing. So this means we are not supposed to do again and again and again and again the testing. Okay. So if we give more UVR exposure, okay, it may lead to more erythemal reactions and premature aging. So please make sure that the test dosage is conducted in a very swift and appropriate manner. Okay. Yes. Now, we cannot do the test dosing size as far as we want. We cannot do it on the forehead. We cannot do it on our face. We cannot do it on wrist. We cannot do it on the back, or we cannot do it foot. Yes, where we are supposed to do the test dosing side, it is very important. Okay. Why do we select the test dosage side? Test dosage side criteria. First one. Okay. Basic criteria. We will go with the PPT slide also. First thing, it should not be exposed to sunlight directly. And second one is, patient can easily access or not access or can easily view the test dosage. This is very much important, my dear students, please understand. Okay, because patients are supposed to see these sites again and again, again and again. Okay, so apart from this, okay, we would see it again. We'll discuss the points in detail. The area students is of importance because the patient is to inspect at regular intervals. A convenient and visible site is essential. That is what I've mentioned in the previous writings. It should be clear of skin disease. Yes, obvious. There should not be any skin disease, because if there is a skin disease, we won't have a appropriate erythema reaction. Okay. Third thing, where we can do it. The basic site is flexor aspect of the forearm. Yes. Okay. If the site is not there, then abdominal and medial aspect of arm or thigh. Okay. So why flexor aspect of the forearm? Because it is very much easy to inspect at regular intervals. Okay, and what care should be taken after UVR? Patient is supposed to ask a long sleeve clothes to avoid direct exposure to the sunlight. Okay, the selected site should be clean with soap and water to remove surface grease. Yes, obvious. Okay, and cover the patient areas, cover the patient other areas if leaving only the forearm exposed to the UVR. So what you are doing, you are just exposing the testing site forearm, okay, to the UVR. You are not exposing anything else. Okay, so please make sure that we do the same things. Yes, this is very important. Generally, we do it on three holes. One being one by one. Or 2x2. If I take 2x2 centimeter, the center one, this is 1x1, and this is 3x3. Okay, so generally there are 3 to 5 hole setups, at least 2x2 centimeters and one apart. Okay, on a lint, paper, cardboard is taken. There are special UVR test dosage strips in the market available. Yes. So they are very much easy, but apart from this, you can have this on paper, you can have this on lint paper, and you can have it on cardboard also. Okay. So what we are doing it, if this is 2 into 2, okay, centimeters. So this will be 1 into 1 centimeter. Okay. And this will be 3 into 3 centimeters. So, this circle is the smallest. Okay, triangle is medium, and the rectangle is your largest part. Okay, so first we will open circle for how much? 30 seconds. The first, no, yes. So what we are going to do, we will open the first hole, that is your circle, for 30 seconds, then second hole for next 30 seconds, and the third one for next 30 seconds. So practically the circle is exposed to 90 seconds, this is exposed to 60 seconds, and this is exposed to 30 seconds. So circle is exposed to 90 seconds. Okay, this is exposed to 60 seconds, and this is exposed to 30 seconds. Okay, so what we are doing is we are opening this hole first hole, which is circle, is opened for 30 seconds, then triangle is open for next 30 seconds and then rectangle is open for next 30 seconds. Yeah, so practically circle is exposed for 90 seconds because it was the first thing to be opened. Okay, first hole to be opened, so that is why it is exposed for 90 seconds and then 60 seconds and then 30 seconds. Thus total test dosage time is 90 seconds or 1 minute 30 seconds. Okay, so this is what our practical approach towards test dosage site is. Please make sure that you have understood this. Okay, apart from this, this cutting is fixed to the forearm with adhesive plaster. This is what we have discussed. Okay, well, how for adhesive plaster, the cuttings are at different sizes and different shape. Why we are doing different sizes and different shape? Because it becomes an easier for the patient to identify in which the erythema came and in which the erythema has not came or it has disappeared. Okay, so to identify the erythema, that is why we are using different kind of shape. This is very important practical viva question. Then as per the lamp instructions, we are supposed to allow the lamp to be warm up perpendicular, okay, to the forearm, and distance of 50 to 80 centimeter is used. Okay, so generally it is 50 centimeters. So based upon the lamp criteria and different books, I have written 50 to 80 centimeters. Expose the first opening for 30 seconds, then the second opening for another 30 seconds, and till the last opening is open for the next 30 seconds. So this means your total openings is in three objects or testing paper is of 90 seconds, 1 minute, 30 seconds. Clear? Okay, so this is what I have mentioned. The first opening would receive the longest exposure time. The last opening would receive the least amount of exposure time. Instruct the patient to monitor the forearm every 2 hours and note which opening or shape appeared pink or red last and when it faded first. This is very, very, very important. Very, very, very important. So here I would like to use bilingual language also. Yes, though there are feedbacks that to give the lecture in English only, but I am here using it in bilingual language, that what we are supposed to see erythemal reaction in the shape where it appeared last and it faded first. Matlab, jisme erythema sabse last aya aur sabse pehle chala gaya, wo erythema humko dhoondna hai. So that is your minimal erythemal dosage. And how we would ask the patients to monitor it, we will make a chart like this. Yes, so this is circle, triangle and rectangle. So every 3 p.m., 7 p.m., 11 p.m., 7 a.m., 11 a.m. we are going to monitor this, because we would see, because why we are seeing it this for 24 hours, because as per the skin type and skin and the dosage, minimal erythemal dosage, the latent period for getting this erythema is 24 hours. The latent period for getting this erythema is 24 hours. So that is why we are going to see this erythemal reaction, which comes last and disappears first in the 24 hour schedule. Okay, so that is why 3 p.m., 7 p.m., 11 p.m. And obviously you are not going to get up. Generally, you go to bed by 11 p.m. So one is not going to get up in between to check. So if we don't get this in this time frame of schedule, we are supposed to do it again and we are supposed to get the erythema reaction. So for example, yes, for example, if I have an erythemal reaction of triangle, yes, which is coming last and which is disappearing first, just giving you an example, or let me say, which is coming at somewhere around 7 p.m. Okay, and it is going at 11 p.m. So this becomes my minimally reachable dose. That is my 60 seconds. 60 seconds matlab 1 minute. So jo, look at the areas at the time shown and place a tick in the box if any reddening is seen. And if no reddening is seen, you put a cross. For example, you'll put a cross over here. You'll put a cross over here. So if there is no reddening which is seen, okay, you have not seen any reddening. So you'll put a cross. इसमें आपको दिखा है तो 7 p.m. को आया which has disappeared which has come last and disappeared first. Okay, so this becomes your erythema dose, so which is your 60 seconds. Okay, now what is minimal erythema dose, which we have already discussed minimal erythema dose. It is a slight reddening of the skin which takes somewhere around 6 to 12 hours. So what is 6 to 12 hours? It is your latent period. Please make sure this is one of the important Viva question, latent period. Okay, 6 to 2 develop. Okay, to develop. Okay, which is just visible at 24 hours. Okay, anything clear? Yes, a very important slide. Yes, I typically take somewhere around 5-10 minutes to explain this slide. Okay, so we have E1, E2, E3 and E4. Okay, so E1 is the minimum dosage. Sabse kam dosage iska hai. So I will donate it. I will denote this with a pink color. Okay, and E4 is the highest. Okay, so E4 is the highest, so this is denoted by red color, and minimal erythema dosage, which is denoted by pink color arrow, so this is the lowest. So this means iska latent period. Okay, this means the latent period will be longer compared to your E4. So latent period and duration of erythema are inversely proportional. Okay, so for example, if this is 6 to 12 weeks, this will be less than 24 hours. This will be less than 24 hours. Okay. If this is 6 hours, this is somewhere around 2 days. If this is 3 hours, this is 3 to 5 days. And this is less than 2 hours a week. Okay. So this is what duration of erythema can stay. Okay. So even obvious being which is the least dosage. Okay. So erythema can stay less than 24 hours. And E4, which is the highest dosage, so erythema can stay up to 4 weeks. Okay. Again, erythema of E1 is 6 to 12 hours. This means there will be no much more skin reaction, no edema, no discomforts, no desquamation. Clear. But in E4, you will have a blister. It will be very painful, discomfort, and thick sheets will happen. Clear. So I'm just giving both the extremities. We'll discuss one by one. So if an even dosage is given, that is your minimal erythema dosage is given, the latent period is of somewhere around 6 to 12 hours. What will be the color of erythema? It will be mild pink. It will be mild pink. And erythema can last till 24 hours. And there will be no as such skin differences seen in even dosage. In windowsage. Clear? E2. It lasts. Latent period is somewhere around 6 hours. Iska matlab 6 ghante ke andar. Isme 6 se 12 ghante ke andar erythema dikh jayega. Isme in 6 hours you will be able to see the erythema. What will happen? E1 was pink color. E2 is somewhere around pink or reddish color. Pink and reddish color. That lasted till 24 hours. This will last till 2 days. Okay, so we are moving on towards the, we are increasing the dosage. So, 24 ghante tha, this is 48 hours. Skin edema will not be there, but a bit discomfort will be there and desquamation will also be there because the dosage is increased. Okay, we will see the relation to it later on. E3, again we are increasing the dosage. So, latent period is of 3 hours. So, first E1 was 6 to 12 hours, E2 is 6 hours. So as we are increasing the dosage, the latent period is decreasing. Okay, so latent period decreasing, erythema is duration of erythema staying will increase. Clear? So E3 latent period is 3 hours. Kab tak erythema reh sakta hai? For 3 to 5 days. And those two, E1 and E2 were more on pinkish color. E3 will be on much more on reddish color. Yes, and obvious being we have increased the dosage, so some edema will be there. It will be painful and it will be in sheets. And as I said, E4 latent period is less than 2 hours. This means in 2 hours you will see the reaction, and it would be red color. It will stay for a week. It will blister, very painful, thick sheets. So this means even if you are giving E1 dosage, the reaction will come in 6 to 12 hours. If you are giving E2, the reaction will come in 6 hours. If you are giving E3, the reaction will come in 3 hours. And if you are giving E4, the reaction will come in next 2 hours, erythemal reactions. Okay, so based on erythemal reactions, which is known as latent period, the duration will be inversely proportional. Okay, so if the erythemal reaction is going to come in 6 to 12 hours in E1, it will stay till somewhere around 24 hours. For our day, it will stay. E2, it will come in 6 hours. It will stay for 48 hours, that is 2 days. E3, it will come in 3 hours. It will stay for 3 to 5 days, that is probably till a week. And E4, it will come in 2 hours and it will stay for a week somewhere around. So that is why, based on this erythema, okay, based on this duration of erythema, we are supposed to progress. So this means E2, E1 dosage can be given after a day. So when do we give another dosage of E1? When we give another dosage of UVR, we always give once the erythema is subsided. So, okay. So as we all know, in 24 hours, till 24 hours, it will stay. So E1 can be given on an regular day basis, day-to-day basis. E2 can be given on an alternate day basis. E3 can be given twice in a week. And E4 can be given once in a fortnight. Okay. So please make sure you have understood this. Okay. Clear. You have different types of skin. This is according to Wolf et al. Okay. 1997. We have type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4, type 5 and type 6. Okay, this is where we will end our UVR dosage. After that, we will move on towards the calculation. So, I will quickly go. E1, type 1, type 2 and type 3, all of them are white skin. Type 4 is olive skin. Type 5 is brown skin. And type 6 is black skin. So, type 1, 2, there are 6 types of skin. And in that, 1, 2 and 3 is white skin. Type 4 is olive skin. Type 5 is brown skin and type 6 is black skin. So as we go on with the types, these skin shades differs. So white skin, which always burns, never tans. Okay, type 1. Type 2 always burns, slightly tans. So okay, burn bhi hota hai, tan bhi hota hai. Type 3, it rarely burns and always tans. Type 4, olive skin, it has shifted. It rarely burns, always tans. Type 5, never burns, always tans. Type 6, never burns and always tan. This is what you are supposed to understand. Okay. So, my suggestions to the students is that type 1 is, it will never tan. Type 2 is slightly tan. Type 3 say, always tans will start. So, till it will last till type 6, always tans. And then only the burns will change. So, you have already memorized that type 1, type 2 and type 3 are white skin. Type 4 is olive skin. Type 5 is brown skin. Type 6 is black skin. Okay, so we have memorized one component. Another component is never tans. That is only in type 1. Then type 2, it is slightly tans. And third, say always tans will come. So now we are supposed to remember the middle component. That is, if there is no tanning, okay, there will be burn. If there is slightly tanning, there will be burn. If always tanning, okay, there will be sometimes burn, rarely burns, never burns and never burns. Okay. So it is very easy to understand if you remember in the way which I have taught you. Yes, as I said, the dosage depends upon how much the output of the lamp, distance between the lamp, angle at radiation is given, sensitivity of the skin and time. So these are the parameters 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 parameters wherein the skin response to the UVR depends. And it is very, very, very important, my dear students, to understand this, because it, as I said, it is meaningless to find out the average output of the lab. Yes, we would see this in a later section, but this is what, if E1 is the minimal erythemal dosage, E2 is 2.5 into E1, E3 is 5 into E1, and E4 is 10 into E1. So just giving you a calculation, if MED is 60 seconds, that is 1 minute. So E2 is equal to 2.5 into 1, which is equal to 2.5 minutes. E3 is equal to 5 into 1, which is equal to 5 minutes. And E4 is equal to 10 into 1, which is equal to 10 minutes. Okay, so this is what minimal erythemal dosage is. So I would like to go to the whiteboard to discuss some basic things which we have discussed in our this lecture. First thing, what we have discussed is minimal erythemal dosage is nothing but minimum dosage required to produce edema, that is, okay. And even you pink color, and it would be 6 to 12 hours will be your latent period, 12 hours, and it will last for less than 24 hours. Less than 24 hours. E2 will be again bit pinkish and reddish, will last for 6 hours. The latent period is 6 hours, will last for 48 hours. E3, third point, E3 is much more onto reddish color. Okay, 3 hours is the latent period, and it will stay for somewhere around 3 to 5 days. And E4 is the highest, so angry red. You will see the reaction in less than 2 hours, and it will stay for a week. So this is what a brief discussion is about, the erythemal reactions. And there are types of skin, that is from total types 6. Okay, so we have learned this types also, total 6 types of skins. And then what we are supposed to do, MED sites, test dosage sites are, first, forearm, second, abdomen, third one is medial aspect of inner thigh. Or, yes, so these are the MED test dosage sites. Why we are using it? We are using it because it should not be exposed to skin directly, and it should not be exposed to sun directly. So that, okay. And then we are seeing the minimal test dosage site. So this is the testing procedure. In next lecture, we will see how we can progress with our dosage. So thank you very much. Thank you very much for listening to me. As usual, I will sign out with a smiling face. And if you have any doubts, please feel free to contact me so that we can discuss in detail about the doubts which you have. Clear? Okay. So we can discuss about our doubts whenever we want. this is a very easiest manner to understand. And please refer John Law and Reed textbook for this. Okay, electrotherapy explained.